You know, if we're being semi-honest, right? If we really want to improve the world, we need to remove what's so addicting and crippling to our society. And you and I both know what we're talking about. Not the fast food. Not the liquor.
Not even the drugs.
That's right, ladies and gentlemen. We're talking about the most addicting one of them all. Video games. I 100%, without a doubt, truly believe that video games will be the downfall of our society. Shit, nigga, video games were almost the downfall of this YouTube channel. And I'm not exaggerating when I say that. Like, bro, if you go to my channel and you look at the gap between my third and fourth video, it's damn near a 2-year gap. And do you know why? Because of video games. I mean, you know, along with schoolwork and depression. But, bro, once you enter the door of becoming a gamer, there's no turning back. And I mean that, bro. Don't act dizzy. Suckers be dying left and right, and I ain't talking about GTA. I need y'all to understand, it ain't no game in these streets. Like, bro, I'll be chilling, right? Just finished a productive day. And then one of my bros will text me, hop on the game. And it's innocent at first, right? Like, you wouldn't assume anything will go wrong. And nothing goes wrong. Like, me and my guys will have a fun time playing Minecraft. And then someone will say, yo, y'all trying to hop on another game? So I'll look at the time and it's like 10 p.m. And I'll be like, man, it's still early. Of course we can hop on another game. So we'll get on a more serious game like Fortnite. Wait, no. Like Warzone. Because if you still play Fortnite in this day and age, you're a child.
Believe it!
Anyways, end up playing one game, and of course I sell because I'm garbage, and our squad ends up losing. And I'm like, man, I can't go out like that. So one game turns into two, then two to four, then by the fifth one, no, the seventh one, if we're lucky, we finally win. And you know how I just said it was 10 p.m.? Oh, well, bam, it's now 1 a.m. Because, bro, just playing one of these games is on average like 30 minutes. And at times, it could be up to an hour. So once you win that game, do you think it ends right then and there? Do you think you just say, all right, guys, that was a good game. I'm about to hop off, though. And everyone else gets off the game as well? Do you think, do you genuinely really believe that that's what really happens? If so, you're 1,000% wrong, because that's never, and I mean never, what ends up happening. Let me tell you what ends up happening. You and your boys will end up playing another game, and another, and another. That happiness and euphoric feeling you felt? Wow, that was some onomatopoeia, I think. Oh, shit. Anyways, that euphoric feeling you felt after winning the game is a feeling you're going to end up chasing. And while you're on the game, nothing else matters except you getting to that high. So I end up playing some more, and I look at the time, and it's like 3 a.m. So by this time, I recognize the things I have to do the next day. So I tell everybody, all right, guys, this is my last game. But that next game comes and goes, and I'm somehow still on the game. And approximately like 4 games after my quote-unquote last game, I finally hop off and decide to go to bed. So I lie down to go to bed, but I can't fall asleep. And when you're in a position like that, you're not left with many options. So you're just tossing and turning and tossing and turning in the dark. And then you just hop on your phone. And if we're being honest, there's only so many entertaining apps on your phone. Like what? There's Instagram, Snapchat, YouTube, and don't forget about TikTok. Because if your For You page is anything like mine, let's just say you'll be on that app for a while. And after that gets boring, you know, you could watch a different kind of video, if you know what I'm saying. You know, like one of my animations on my YouTube channel. Or by the time you finish watching whichever video of your choice, you put the phone down, then close your eyes. But then you hear something that's faint at first, but then it gets louder and louder and louder until you hear it at your window. Then you realize the sound you were hearing the whole time is fucking birds. I was able to stay up so long that not only did the birds come out, so did the sun. And I realized I had to make a choice. I could either stay in bed until I eventually fall asleep, which would probably happen in the next 40 minutes to an hour, but I have to wake up for work. So I'd end up getting 3 hours of sleep. 4 if I'm lucky. And nigga, I am not one of those people who could just function off a few hours of sleep. What could end up happening is me sleeping through all of my alarms, my morning routine not getting done, and I'd end up being late for work, and my job loves firing people. Or I could pull an all-nighter and end up being tired and groggy for the peak of the day. Meaning, when I get home from work, instead of doing things productive like working out and animating, I'd end up just falling asleep,
for hours.
But do you know what's crazy? Even though video games mess up my sleep schedule, that's not even the biggest problem. My biggest problem is my emotions, my anger more specifically when it comes to this. Like, bro, I'm not gonna lie. When it comes to playing the game, it's painfully hard for me not to get angry. I'm not kidding. All it takes is one.
Goodbye, my nigga. Back to the lobby.
And I will be heated. And it's at that point where I'm ready to commit murder. But I can't do that. I can't do that. But a more acceptable substitute would be punching something. And y'all should already know, these hands don't discriminate. You might as well call them pansexual, because anyone and anything could get it. Like, I'll legitimately feel really bad for my chair. I've hit this chair so many times that I think it has PTSD. It probably on a daily basis gets flashbacks about when I gave it those Mike Tyson hands over a game of Roblox. Even though nothing in my room is safe from my rage, I do try and chill on the expensive shit, cause like, doing something like this would be a very regrettable decision in the long run, to say the least. So, all in all, kids, stay away from video games unless you want your life ruined. Also, add my gamer tag on Xbox. It's on the screen right here. Yeah. Yo, how y'all doing on this fine evening? I'm doing great. And I'm assuming you are too, because you just watched another video by yours truly. It's great to see y'all, man. Well, can't technically see y'all, but y'all understand what I'm saying. I wanted to inform y'all on something real important. If y'all follow my animation Instagram account, which is in my channel bio, it doesn't matter, I'm gonna put the link to the account, Instagram account, in the you know, description of this video. But if you follow the Instagram account, y'all will see updates on animations I'm working on, and I'm gonna start posting some clips and videos onto there. The link to that is in my bio, you know. So, you know, go ahead and follow that. My boys right here on the screen are already following. So, like, come on, man. What are you waiting for? Along with that, y'all know what I'm about to say. Make sure to like and share this video if you did it already, and subscribe and join the family. Help your boy reach 1,000 subscribers. And if you haven't even subscribed yet, bro, you're not a part of the gang, bro. Like, plain and simple. But hey, listen, it's not too late. You could click that subscribe button right there and turn on that post notification bell. All right. Anyways, y'all, make sure to do all those things I said earlier. And I will see all of y'all in the next video. Peace.